Hi friends, welcome to the fundraise series. Today we will discuss about a very important topic in the shareholder agreement, and that is the reserve matters or the protective rights. Reserve matter or the protective rights are some of the actions which a company can take only when the investors do the veto power. So basically you have to take the consent of the investors before getting or before doing any of those actions. Basically, protective rights or reserve rights are the powers given to the investors wherein wherein the company will be able to take those actions only with the veto or with the consent of investors. Now there are four main areas wherein the investors want to protect their rights and want to draft the reserve matters in such a way. The number one is with regard to change in the terms of the agreement or fresh issue of shares at a preferential or an equal right. So basically, if an investor has invested in a company at certain terms, the founder of the company cannot go and unilaterally change those terms. Second point is with regard to the preferential issuance of shares or equal at a preferential right or at an equal right. So the earlier investors might use his veto power if the company is trying to issue fresh shares with at a preferential rights or equal right vis-a-vis the earlier investor. The second area is with regard to the licensing of IP rights, closure of the company, bankruptcy and other issues with regard to sell of the company. So these are the areas wherein the investors would want to have his consent, and that's the reason he has a veto right on those things. The third area is with regard to creation of more companies in terms of subsidiaries, holding company, changing the structure of the company, changing the objective or the business model of the company. In this area also, the investors wants to use the veto power. The fourth area is with regard to the day-to-day operation in terms of the expenses, in terms of the spending power, in terms of budgets, in terms of deviation in the budget, in terms of spending on a particular item more than what was there in the budget. So I think these are the four main areas which we have seen in our experience over the years when we review the shareholder agreement. And to our view, a shareholder agreement, the reserve matters should be such that wherein it serves both the purpose. That is, it gives the flexibility to the founder to run the company on a day-to-day basis, and also gives enough comfort and protection to investors in terms of the terms and in terms of anything which can alter their rights in the company. If we have a balanced reserve matters drafted, this can really work well for the company. So that's it for today. We will come back with more videos on fundraise series. Till then, bye.